If you have the will and a moment to spare, it's a beautiful world out there. It's a beautiful world out there. It can be a bit frightening, something you don't know. You need a little enlightening, it'll make you grow. Hey guys, good morning. Welcome to yet another episode of Beautiful Minds. And today we have a beautiful mind, Amit, who is joining us today. He's the founder and CEO of Fascino Entertainment. I know Amit was into body care and now he's also moved into entertainment and into fashion. So we will get to know more about Amit. Amit, hum jana chahte hain aapke baare mein. How you got into body care? Why beauty was something which you felt was important? And why, with so many international brands and all that available, why you wanted to, you know, create a new brand? And what was, you know, going on your mind when you decided to quit a lovely job and get into building this particular brand for India? Over to you, Amit.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Actually, I started my career, as everybody does, with my job. Basically, I was a journal head. Where my salary was handsome, like 1.5 lakh. But still, there was something in my mind. I was in, basically studied my medical diploma. Mm-hmm. After that, I was still went into civil engineering field in oil and gas sector, which was curiosifying me at that period of time, where I was thinking a salary of 1.5 lakh is more than enough for us. So I joined there. I spent 9 years of there, where around 300 employees were working under me. But mm-hmm. still, I wasn't satisfied, and seeing the growth rate, so I was actually looking for the growth rate studies during my course of job, where I saw that beauty growth rate was 2000%, whereas any other growth rate was only 100-200% in world. So then I felt that I have only like 20 years of my life, and I am in the, whether I am in the right track or wrong track. Mm-hmm. Because I was looking for my long-term perspective rather than a short-term. Short-term, I was very happy with my things, what I was getting. But after seeing the stats and studies about the beauty care in the world, which was 2000% growth rate, I thought, what the hell I'm doing in this field, whereas I'm a doctor, why shouldn't I go back to my that own field, which has a growth rate? Because oil and gas sector, steel industries, everything was on the diminishing model. So then I thought that, okay, I can go, but how will I start my career? Whereas I don't have any basic knowledge. Mm-hmm. So then I started looking at job opportunities in this sector. Suddenly I got a contract from a label where I was only offered $50,000 as my salary. So even though I was getting 1 lakh salary lesser than what my previous salary, I entered in that sector and I worked there for 1.5 years as a commercial head, which was my core strength actually. Then after seeing all the inputs and outputs, I came to understand basically what is this industry and how the growth rates are happening in this industry. Why? And during that course of time, I found that beauty parlor industry is getting it down and cosmetology industry is getting it boomed. So okay. I did various cosmetology simultaneously and I entered into cosmetic sector. After entering that, I found that there is a huge gap of machineries which are not made in India and which are directly imported from China. And as I was with in touch in oil and gas sector with all engineers and all, it was very easy for me to understand the equipments, the motherboard, circuit board, designing, energy, power deliberation, which is playing a very vital role. Because when you come to a hair removal machine, you get it from 70,000 to 9 lakh. So person are not known what to buy, which to buy. So then I found that gap and I decided that I should start with my equipment business first. Along with that, I should open my clinic. So after starting my equipment business, I got good encouragement because none of the people, biomedical engineers, were focusing this sector, particular sector.
Right.
Everybody was coming, selling machine and no service, no backup. So we started first time in South India, we will give a supply service to all the people who are buying these machines, to the doctors. Like that, I got a chain of doctors. Then I understood more and more gaps in this field. I started my brand called Fascino, which was started with my equipments and clinic. So, and over a period of time, we become pioneer in South India in our equipment business, which made us a core stability, because body care, healthcare, it becomes a brand within a year or 2 years of spending time, giving feedbacks, clientele. You need sustaining time for that period. So that at that given period of time, my earning was coming from healthcare business. And we were focused to cheat our clients, basically, to give a genuine treatment, whether we are in profits or loss. That was our motto. Rather than selling a big packages, genuine treatment with reasonable. And I saw that this cosmetology was only for the upper class. I saw VLCC, Colors, many other brands. They are targeting big, big packages and was for upper class. Then I got that, see, if I want to get stable in the market, I want middle class and lower class, where I should be pricely friendly. And as basically we are Marwadis, we know volume business only. So I came up with the same results with minimum pricing for the mass. That made us to grow slowly and gradually. And over a period, we established our franchises. We sold some franchises in Chennai, Coimbatore. People started approaching me with different level. Amit will buy machine. We are opening new center. Why don't you give your brand only, which you have already made successful, and the formulas, what you are doing treatment, because I made my own formulas now. So when they said that, why don't you only give us a support and give us a franchisee? So like that, we got a franchisee concept and we went to Franchisee India and started selling franchises, and we happily got 3-4 franchises, and further we were looking. Over a period of this time, again, body care was set up business. We were getting whatever I expected, I got almost. And certain growth you will get after a strategic time only. You have to wait for that time, sustaining period you need.
Yeah.
So wasting, instead of wasting that time, I thought, what all are needed? What are the correlated business with this? I should do that. Suddenly this pandemic happened. So during this pandemic, what we did, we started with Fasino sanitizers, Fasino hand wash, Fasino mask, PP kits. Now we are launching Fasino sunscreen, body lotion, moisturizer, cosmetic range completely. We have taken all the license approvals with us. And I procure a factory now in Pulmeru, where we will manufacture our own products and sell into the market.
Superb journey. I think, you know, this is a good story for all the startups, all the people who are looking to start something into fashion industry. I think this is a remarkable, you know, story and learning which they can, you know, find from your story. So good journey.
This was Fasino Healthcare, and how you asked me that, why I started entertainment. See, our business is totally dependent on the beauties and beautiful people who like their lifestyle to be cute, smart, handsome. And that is there in only in entertainment. And from past 2 years of during my course of this promotion of Fasino Body Care, I used to sponsor each and every entertainment people.
Yeah, I know. I know you. And that's when I met you once in one of the events. So good. So nice of you. I think you should be present in that industry.
Then I thought that these models are also seeing and very struggling in their life. There is no proper grooming given. There is no proper portfolio shoots made for them. Then slowly and gradually, Mumbai actresses, regularly they come for treatment for me here. They told me, why don't you sponsor small song? You are sponsoring this much. Why don't you sponsor us? Then slowly, gradually, I said that to sponsor, what is my financial security, I asked. So they told me, you open your fashion entertainment company, sponsor from that, keep the rights of that song with you unless and until it is sold. So during this course of time, Bhojpuri actresses, actually, they supported me a lot. They made me a song from Fasino Entertainment. They sold it out to Venus and all. So, they brought me in this. So, LeBron, now when, during the course of discussion, however, I'm going in fashion shows, event, and I'm associated with Gen X Fashion Weeks and all. So, this time, I thought that why shouldn't I do Fasino Mr. and Miss Telangana? So, I took it as a challenge. We did it. Auditions at Hyperlocal, and it has gone away some. I should not grow. That is the reason people kept 3 auditions other on the same day when I was, my auditions were there. But by the grace of God, by the other people, we were overcrowded during my budget. What I felt was 70 member crowd was the maximum what I felt. but 100 people turned up and 140 people are on in audition 2. I'm waiting. And everything went smooth and beyond my expectations. So I thought that might be these industries also favoring my luck. And we should go now making songs, videos. Yesterday I signed a deal with making a song in Hindi. Mm-hmm. We will release it on January 26th in New Year. And it will be, song will be on Independence Day itself.
Mm-hmm.
It will be a nation. So something, see, we have to sponsor somewhere. Why do I do sponsor in a correct direction with our brand name rather than promoting any third party?
True. You know, most importantly, what you're doing is you're encouraging those new artists, budding artists, you know, and they will always remember you because you are the first one to sponsor them. They will remember you. They will support you for the entire life and their entire career. That's very important. I think that's a very good initiative and thought process to sponsor somebody who is like budding. Yeah, famous artists and all that's good. You know, they'll come. They might have a lot of face value and all that. But, you know, what the value which you give back to them is also very important. So, pretty good initiative.
As I worked earlier in corporate, mm-hmm. I started building up a team. So, that team is now growing and promoting me somewhere, which even now, it is beyond my control now. So, I say people, they work for themselves. Everybody will do that. When people start working with you, working for you, nobody can stop your growth.
True.
So you should have a team where people should support you and promote you. So from the day one, the concept what I kept, whether it was my healthcare, whether it is body care or it's an entertainment, I shouldn't work for myself. Some 50, 10, 20, I should encourage team which should work for me. When that going to happen, nobody can stop my growth. That is my motto, basically. And that is my business formula.
Superb. So how do you manage your... So Amit, in this entire journey, who all were your team members who supported you and, you know, they always kept you saying that, Amit, don't give up. Yes, we are there. We are in the right direction.
So actually, there is not one person behind me. Like photographer John.
Mm-hmm.
He is there with me from long past 3 years. Farooq, Rafiq, Genex. He is there from years together. My team members like Samir, Sujata, Madhu, Dr. Maria, Dr. Hari Kiran, Dr. Nandakishore, who are the well-known doctors in city. It is very difficult to say one name because again, I will be in a jail. They will catch me. You didn't tell my name. Because my growth is not because of one person. It is multiple factors and multiple people are involved. Because I'm not into one business. So every business is correlated to each other. And numbers of my friends, my colleagues, who saw that, yes, he has something, he will do something in life. We have to support him by good or bad, whatever it happens, we have to support him. So few supported commercially, few supported monetarily, few supported whatever best they can do. So it is very difficult to say one or two names. It's not that. It's a team. I'm telling you, undisclosed team.
Undisclosed, a strong team who's behind your success.
Actually, I have followers, supporters from Chennai, Delhi, Bombay, Dubai. Few people supported from US. So it's not one. And few people, even I don't know, they started supporting after seeing my post, my growth, and my hard work during lockdown. So it's multiple things are involved. Few ministers who just met me in event management after seeing my hard work. They started giving me opportunities in Dubai, like our state representative, Dejavat sir. So there is not even one person I can say. From that, again, few many people started joining. So it's not a one.
True. You also have Bhojpuri fans. You know, so soon you will have so many Bhojpuri fans who will follow you because you have sponsored music videos for them.
That's all I'm saying. In UP, our sanitizer, Fascino brand, has it is competing Patanjali.
Oh my God.
I don't know how it became. That name has been because rewards we have got in hand wash. So we don't know what is happening where. And Kunal Aditya Rajput, who did the acting in that song, as a friendship of token of love, he didn't even charge me.
Okay. Good signs. I think win-win. So, what's your take on dusky skins? Aajkal, you know, just being fair is not the mantra. In beauty, things have changed. You know, people are also accepting if somebody is not that fair. So, what's your take on that?
So, basically, the presentation matters a lot. It's black, white, I never care. The way they present, the way they get groomed, and the skin texture, how smooth, how finishing, and how well maintained. And I want to be a role model for my people. And they say that at 40s, you look like this, which you never look like 40s. So you make me like you. Because collagen improvement, it needs a basic guidelines. People think that cosmetology is a very costly treatment. So they try to avoid and go to beauty parlors. But that is not the fact. If they get the correct doctors and correct team, it is as equal to their beauty parlor expenses.
True.
And it will be a genuine growth.
That's a good point.
Color improvement matters. So you can see our models also, we are not looking at the color. We are looking on the talent basically.
So can you talk about the fashion activity with respect to, you know, Mrs. Telangana, the new pageant which you're rolling out?
So basically, Miss Telangana, we are making a model grooming, which everybody generally does. But along with the grooming, the advantage if they are getting with us, I do at least 10 events a year. And everywhere they will be promoted. Because see, show a chance after taking a small grooming charges, everybody gives them. But proper promotions title, nobody does that. And the advantages with us is that we have our own in-house product team, cosmetology team. So we do promotions for our Fascino brand. So my these models only will be my Fascino faces for my products. So directly or indirectly, their posters, promotions will be done by me itself. So that they will get at least a basic portfolio where they can show to the audience or public wherever they are getting an opportunity. And already multiple people are associated with me, film directors and all. So already my Facebook page is watched by everyone. So whichever talent comes on that page will be highlighted, will get an opportunity. And rest, what we do is we leave on them. And it's an individual call of the director and the participant to talk directly. We share number each other. We never be a part of other. And it is a crystal clear transparency.
Yeah, that's really important.
In our fashion show, we are going to launch first time in India drone cameras in fashion show in the history of India.
Superb.
So, something happening.
Okay. So, Amit, can you? I mean, there are a couple of them who might be interested in taking a franchisee for your products because you've already established the product. The product is successful. It's been tried, tested. It is. Not, you know, it's built or, you know, it's been backed up by dermatologists who are behind the scene. So, kya chahiye unke liye? Kya requirement hai? If they have to take up the franchisee, whom should they contact? And, you know, what are the prerequisites you take? You know, franchisee banne ke liye unke liye kya dekhte hain aap?
See, generally, any franchisee model in India, wherever you go, you see any franchisees, it's either one-sided where any company takes all the money and say, franchisee, you run the show. It's Domino, any brand, XYZ. In our case, what we have done is 50-50 co-partnership. Interiors have to be made by them. Equipment cost would be by the company. So the same interior tomorrow, if they are not willing to continue the franchisee, for an example, we should think of good and bad as well. At that period of time, machinery depreciation, which is the major, will be borne by the company. Interior depreciation is borne by them. And the same interior they can use for same the other business also, which is their property. And what we are basically looking is the counter person and the chair person. A family member of them is mandatory to take the franchisee. If they are feeling that we will invest money and employee will take care, our company will not give franchisee. Why? Because this is service industry. We have to pin and point on the services. And in service industry, you can survive only if your service is good. An employee will give service, but time to time. Beyond time, sometimes you need to satisfy and look at the public grievances and make them happy is the mantra of a service industry, which an owner can only do. So owner representative should be a part of the team and take responsibility, and that too female. We are encouraging women entrepreneurship, as Fascino Body Care is also owned by a woman, my wife, and we encourage only women entrepreneurships when it comes to body care.
Cool. I like that, because the interior is them. You're taking care of the major cost, which is the equipment. Okay. You know, this is the first time I'm seeing where, you know, somebody is taking the ownership of the major costs. Okay. And, you know, it's a right point what you made. So yeah, anybody who is interested in fashion, if you're really, really interested in body care, making others beautiful, and want to take a franchise because this is an established brand already, you know, do connect with Amit and team. You can connect. I mean, we've also shared the website details. You can go inquire, connect with them, and you know, have a discussion as to how you can make it a win-win situation to take this particular brand forward and do a business in your own location. So Amit, what is this episode is about beautiful minds. What is that one suggestion you have for beautiful minds out there jo regular job nahi karna chahte, kuch hatke karna chahte, kuch to karna chahte apne life mein, like, you know, the trigger what you had, that, you know, next 20 years is mine, how do I want to beautify it? And, you know, you've done it really well. You've really you know, knitten your story well. Bahut acha life banaya aapne, you know, with this 3 to 4 years of, you know, the struggle. So what is that suggestion you have for others?
So Fascino means beautiful, basically. So our the question what you ask is a beautiful, and Fascino itself a beautiful. That is the name. Reason I choose the word Fascino. Many people have asked me that why you choose this word, Fascino. There are multiple words. And basically this Fascino we started in 1990, where my mother used to take care a beauty parlor.
Oh.
So we are not from today. I reborn it and made a new name.
Super.
And the people who want to do creative things, first they should have a confidence in themselves. And people surrounding to you will discourage because they know you well. They know your weaknesses. You should forget that. And I have fight with my colleagues also when they talk negative. I say when I'm prepared for the negative, but never talk about that. I want only positive things. Because when I went to Amarnath, I learned one thing. I've been to almost all the holy places. So I learned one thing. If you are positive, you will get positive. If you are negative, you will get negative. So I never talk about negative. Even though negative happens, I look positive in that and move forward. Might be it is a lesson for me. Further, I should not bear a losses. So it's not that people see me that I'm well established, happy, growth, XYZ. I had my past also where I was in losses, bad time, negative time. But at the end, if it is good, it is good. There is no talking about bad. So people should not think about bad. They should think only about good. So the good will happen. If we want to talk negative, we can talk about anybody. But it doesn't attract. And in short time, if they are looking for the prospectives, they should talk negative only. If you are looking real-time goal and success, you should talk negative, positive. But it will take time. They should have patience for it.
True.
Then only they can achieve the targets. And anybody interested in segments related to this, now my next aim is to come up with bakery itself.
Wow.
So I don't know. And what you are saying me successful, this is not the my part. Down the line, 10 years, my target is Fascino should be not less than worth of 100 crores. That is basically my target. I am just gone up only to the second step of my life. more 8 steps I have to climb.
Superb, superb. Thank you, Amit, for joining on the show and sharing the insights from your beautiful mind. Because there are very few people जो ये करते हैं and you know you are one of them जो हटके करते हैं जो successful भी होते हैं. हटके बहुत लोग करते हैं, try करते हैं, but you know there are only few who are successful out of this. You are one of them. And I really like the way you have. Yeah, please.
People हटके करते हैं लेकिन team नहीं बनाते, वो failures है. You make a case study of that, you will come to know the basic reason. The people who did same or other than, but they had a good team, they are successful. The people who worked with the team, whether it's Ratan Tata, Aditya Birla, anybody had, who Reliance, who had got the team. Why Reliance is going this speed, if you do a case study properly, which I did, it's only he take the toppers and make a good team, and owner is sitting idle like me, don't know anything, but the team works. So if you make a team only, you can grow. Don't think of individual profits. That is the basic problem in India, what I saw.
True. Yeah, very true. So thank you, Amit. And thank you all the friends who are watching this. So do connect with Fascino if you need any requirement, if you want to participate in the events they're showcasing. And do follow Amit. We will share his social handle because he is the most happening man in this fashion industry. You know, earlier only in Telangana, but now he's completely spread across. So do follow him. And any requirement related to franchisee, do connect with him and, you know, his team will get in touch with you. So thanks a lot, friends. Thanks a lot, Amit, for being part of this Beautiful Mind series and sharing your insights. Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Thank you.